you will be so excited about what you've seen and who you've met that your life will never be the same again. Brother Richard here.
Thank you. You guys, we've been talking about a field trip we had planned. We talked about it back in October of last year. So we selected a group of kids to attend a jazz workshop this coming Saturday, February 6th. And I met this gentleman, Mr. Ocie Davis, last month. And I asked him to come out of school to help speak with your kids about music education, jazz music, his love for art of jazz. And he said, wonderful, we would be grateful if you come out and meet our kids and meet some of our board members. So I'd like to introduce the group here to Mr. Ocie Davis.
Good morning, young people. How are you guys doing?
Good.
All right. First of all, I'd like to thank Richard for bringing me here this morning to address all of you. I feel honored and privileged to look at your bright young faces and to express my experiences as a musician and as a young man as I was coming up and how I found my way to where I'm at today. And for me to be standing here speaking to you all, I'm excited about it. This is wonderful right here. This is really wonderful. I've been in Charlotte for 3 years now. I'm originally from Los Angeles, California. I was born and raised there. Went to high school there. Was in a marching band. I came up, my dad was a musician. He played drums. So he always had me playing drums. I was always hanging out with him. Then I moved to New Orleans in 1995 to study music. So I grew up in Los Angeles when Snoop Dogg and all this hip-hop was going on with Dr. Dre and Corrupt, Tupac. Then I moved to New Orleans when we had Master P, the Hot Boys. So I was around that time when hip-hop was burgeoning, when it was flowing from city to city, from state to state. So I have a lot of experience coming up in that era. And dealing with music, I found my path to jazz music. Now, jazz music, you may be saying, I don't know too much about jazz, old music. But it's a lot of truth in jazz, a lot of history in jazz. The reason why we're here today is because of jazz. It has a lot to do with the United States, America. There would be no jazz if it wasn't for the United States of America. That is America's art form, okay? Invented here in this country right here. Now, we all know what this is. This is a drum set, first of all. You know what a cymbal is. You know what a snare drum is. I've heard it before. This is a bass drum. This is a hi-hat. Another cymbal, smaller cymbal. Now, this instrument right here that you guys are looking at, it's a scaled down version of the real thing. I know you've seen toms and a bunch of cymbals, other drummers playing all kinds of stuff, but that's unnecessary for what I'm doing today. This is called a skeleton kit because it's the essentials. You have a bass drum, snare drum, hi-hat, cymbal. Okay? That's what that is. Now, this instrument is a relatively new instrument. The drum set has not always been here. Now, you guys always know there have been drums. In Africa, we always came up playing drums, but the drum set is a new invention. Why is it a new invention? Because in America, in New Orleans, where jazz happened, you had one guy playing the snare drum, you had one guy carrying a bass drum, one guy hitting the cymbals. You had three people playing one instrument. Okay? So as the music progressed, they found a way to condense it all. Okay, let's make one guy play everything, see if you can do that. So they got on the back of wagons, hay rides, and one guy played the drum set. So you eliminated other people. I'm sure it took money out of their pockets as well. That's how this instrument evolved to what we have today, is a drum set. Okay? So before I speak any further, you guys, I'm going to play a little bit so you guys can hear the drums, hear what I do. And if it gets too loud, just raise your hand or something, okay? I play as soft and as controlled as I can. But sometimes it gets kind of loud. That's what drums are. Drums can get loud and simple. So if it gets too loud, just raise your hand. But look crazy at me or something. And I'll be able to turn it off. All right, here we go.
Thank you.
Los Angeles, I started getting into jazz, and I found out that jazz was born in New Orleans. So the logical choice was for me to go somewhere where I can learn, which is New Orleans. Let me go somewhere to the birthplace of jazz, see what I can learn. So I get to New Orleans, which is a city of drummers. You got all these kids like you guys who grow up in New Orleans, which is part of the culture. You have rhythm, you got all this music, and they grow up in it. The food, everything, right? So here I am, an outsider coming in to a new city where it's nothing but drummers. So I was meeting guys that are younger than me, older than me, they all play drums fantastically. So I had to humble myself and be like, what can I learn here? What can I learn? Because I'm coming from LA, we're kind of cocky, you know, I'm like, you know, West Coast. Let me go to New Orleans and learn a little something. So anyway, I humble myself, pay my dues, and this is what I do for a living, man. I've traveled all over the world. I've been to Japan, I've been to China, I've been to Austria, I've been to Germany, I've been to Cuba, and just last summer I was in Switzerland playing my instrument. This is what I do. So I started when I was 7 years old, you guys. I'm 41 now. So I haven't been playing from 7 to 41. There are times in my life where I have to find my way. But one thing I realized is I was always good at this right here. So I kind of took it for granted. When I was coming up, I could play the drums great. Everybody knew Ocie could play the drums. It was cool. But as I got older, I said, what else can I do? So I tried different things. I tried electric school. I tried computers for a little while. I tried even a corporate gig, you know, working on computers and trying to make a living that way. But it didn't really feel, I didn't enjoy myself. I wasn't really having a lot of fun. So one day, I was hanging out with my cousins and my uncles, and they had it easy. They were just hanging out in the streets, you know what I mean? Drinking, smoking, whatever. It was easy, okay? But that wasn't the way for me. So I had to ask myself, what can I do? And I always came back to the drums. This is when I was 24, you guys. 24 before I realized that I was good at this. So once I made up my mind, this is what I love, this is what I wanted to do, I went for it. And I'm thankful today to be standing here speaking with you guys to say this is what I do for a living. And I support my family. I have a wife, I have two daughters, doing this right here. I teach it, I travel, I perform everywhere, all over the place. So I just want to let you guys know that find what you want to do. You guys are young right now, so you guys are searching. But when you find something that you're good at, stick with it. Stick with it. Stick with it. Find something that you're good at, stick with it. So, if you guys have any questions, please.